Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about how to build a bass trap. All right, first off, let's define some terms. There really is no such thing as a bass trap, okay? Bass or low frequency energy is not trapped by anything. I have built structures, three walls on separate foundation, 8-inch poured concrete thickness of the walls with airspace between each wall, remembering on separate foundations. And I've still had 30 cycle bleed through that. So we don't trap low frequencies, we manage them, okay? We try to get as much absorption as we can in the smallest amount of space. Now we all know from my past videos that there's three types of low frequency absorption. There's diaphragmatic, there's Helmholtz, okay? And there's membrane. Membrane is the cousin or brother, so to speak, of diaphragmatic, and Helmholtz is a more specific frequency-specific resonator that takes special design processes and measurements. So we like to stay with the membrane and the diaphragmatic. We like the diaphragmatic because you get the most horsepower per square foot of any of the three technologies. The other side of the coin with that is they're very heavy, and there's a lot of pieces in the build. So let's look at a cross-section of one of those diaphragmatic absorbers, and ours in particular. We have three main parts to a diaphragmatic absorber. We have the front wall, we have the cabinet, and then we have the internal cabinet fill. And you can see in this diagram, we have the cabinet, we have the two front walls, which are out of phase with each other. Those slow the low frequency pressure down. As the low frequency pressure enters the inside of the cabinet, it is then in a lower pressure area. So we have absorption occurring. And then some completely leaves the cabinet and doesn't get treated at all. So it's this balancing act between cabinet, dual front wall, and internal fill material. So the internal fill material on our low frequency absorbers is our carbon technology. Now we offer both. You can license the carbon and buy the carbon from us, build your own cabinet, build your own front walls, and all of those issues. The key to diaphragmatic absorption is density. The cabinet has to be a certain density. The internal fill material has to have a certain absorption coefficient, and the dual front walls have to have a certain density to correspond with the density of the cabinet. The other factor in building a bass trap is to have the maximum depth of the cabinet for the resonant frequency that you're trying to design for. Anyone can build a box that will absorb 40 cycles worth of energy. The key is how much of that 40 cycle energy are you getting in your box? And that's where the internal fill material comes in, the dual front wall construction, and the density of the cabinet. Hope all this helps. We offer a DIY series on our website, and you can build your own, and we'll be happy to assist you with the process. So if you've got some carpentry skill set, please, you can do this. If you have a table saw, you can build these cabinets, and we can help you if you run into any problems. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.